got a chance to see possibly what the 2020 holiday Jordan 11 will look like. Still early on, but more importantly, let's talk about something I don't think a lot of videos are ever made on, and that's fine. That's what I am here for. A lot of how to cop videos, but never how to afford videos. Well, hello, here I am. I surround my soul with the positivity. That's why I don't worry about the things that I don't see. Yeah. These days I don't worry about much. I think we should have some more fun. I still dream about the days when we were young. What's up, everybody? It's your girl TJ back with another video, Talks with TJ, aka TJ 2 Shoes Change. I hope you guys are having an amazing day. When you're viewing this, I think it's on a Tuesday. I wanted to make sure I got this video out the last week in May because it's very crucial to the time frame for the message in the video. So thank you so much for tuning in. I have no idea what brought you here, but thank you so much. Go ahead and hit the subscribe button if you like what you see, as well as stick around, watch other videos, whether it's sneaker related content, budget content, money management, life talks. I try to incorporate more than just kicks. That's certainly it. Hashtag because sneakers, that's what brings us all here. But life is about more than just kicks. And that being said, there are tons of videos about releases that will touch on how to cop the shoe. And those are very, very important. I actually had a customer come in the other day to Kids Foot Locker. And she said, well, my son really wants these Yeezys. I have no idea how to get them. Okay, you all know I don't buy Yeezys. I don't spend money on Yeezys. Absolutely not. I don't. Inquired, hey, do you watch YouTube? She's like, I'm sure my son does. Okay, tell your son to simply type in the search how to cop whatever shoe, and I guarantee you videos will show up. Because when you all even venture to my channel, hey, how do I cop this? How do I cop that? Respectfully, that's not my lane in this space. You have Unbreakable Kicks, you have Jumperman Chris, you have Sniper Jones, you have Flight Academy Kicks. You have other channels that are great at providing you that information. They are on it, and some of them are very much so in the loop when it comes to certain styles or brands, you know, such as Adidas and Yeezy. Jumperman Chris is great for that. So certainly go to those channels, because even if there is a shoe that I'm maybe curious about that I wouldn't normally go after, that, then listen, that's where I can go as well. There's certain information that I may need. I go watch their channels too. So I would advise you, if you're looking for how to cop, then go there. I mean, you can always try, you know, just walking into a store. That's something you can always certainly do. But other channels have all that information for you. For me though, when you come here, it's about how to afford. And I know someone can say, hey, well, why does this video even need to be made? What do you mean how to afford? You walk in and you pay for the shoe, or you hit submit purchase and the money is taken out of your account online. Yeah, that's all well and good, but listen, when has helpful information ever been bad? I don't think it's ever been a bad thing. So I'm going to provide some helpful information. Now I'll go ahead and show you a few of my favorite predominantly black Jordan 11 sneakers, because that's really what this is. As of right now, it's an all suede upper Jordan 11. So this is still one of the best non-OG colorways for the Jordan 11, and we know it's a 7210. Now this thing is beat to hell, but it looks way worse than when people see it on camera or in pictures. But I mean, it's beat up in person too, let's not get that wrong. But the actual shoe itself, because it is a leather upper, you can beat the shoe up so much more than you can a traditional mesh upper. Now the suede on the back is what looks terrible after a lot of wear. I mean, the stitching can kind of, I mean, yeah, it's had its time. It's done its job. It's had its time. But this leather, I mean, it was nice. It was soft, even on the GS pairs. Now this, I might've gone up a size in this. What is this? I would do a 6 or 6.5, and 11s, I just want the shoe all the time. What is this? 6.5. Okay. I would love to get another pair of 7210s. Now, I don't want to pay the price for them, but I would really, really love to get them. And then this baby here. Do you guys see it? Do you see how pristine it still looks in the back? Now, I don't do mini lace swaps on sneakers outside of what comes with the shoe, but I actually did. This is like a while back, order laces for these, and they actually have it's fully laced, and they actually have just the hyper blue tips on the end. So I just thought that was a nice little subtle touch, nothing too wild or too crazy. Now, I don't wear these a lot. I really should pay more respect to them and wear them more. I have this pair. I also have the 45 on the back. They are just, you know, in the closet. But okay, so those are the predominantly all black upper 11s I have. Let's talk about how to afford these shoes. Because to me, the Jordan 11, again, we fall into these traps, right? It can be bad for you. And I only say that because it's always around the holiday season. So much is going on during the holiday season. No matter what, no matter who you are, you have Thanksgiving, you're probably traveling then. I don't know about this year and how that's all gonna work for people. But usually, let's just think usually, you're traveling for Thanksgiving, you're traveling possibly for Christmas, you're trying to buy gifts for yourself, family, friends, all of that. It all is encompassed into one short time period within about 30 days, and it's bad. So let's start now. Let's look at what the prices will be. Let's look at what it would cost you for a full-size family run. And then from there, we'll get all the way into the how to afford, because we want to make sure you are set and ready in November, not December. We don't want to get ready. We got to stay ready. So when December hits, because as of right now, December 12th is the official release day, we want to make sure that we don't have to worry about getting ready. We ready, okay? We ready. So the price point set for the Bread 11, for the Jordan 11 for 2020, for this holiday season, for men, it's $220. For grade school, which is 3.5 through 7. So ladies, if you, whatever your size is in women's, just go down a size and a half, and that's going to be your grade school size. And then preschool is actually upped as well. So it's $95 a pair. And then toddler, which is 4C to 10C, because it only includes hard bottoms, that'll be $75. Now, I'm not sure what they will do for soft bottoms, if they do soft bottoms. Sometimes they do, sometimes they don't. I haven't seen anything yet for it. If they were to do a soft bottom sneaker, I bet you they go up to $55 or something, just because a lot of prices have been elevated. So if we're looking at tax, now I can only look at tax in my area to keep it fair and reasonable. And I know some people say, how you guys have to pay tax. Yes, in a lot of states, there's sales tax on items that you buy. I know that's why for based on where you live, but we have sales tax, okay? So here in Indiana, or where I specifically live in this city, this area, this county, you're paying 7%. So we're trying to get one pair for men's, grade school, preschool, and for toddler, you're looking at $610. Now, when I did this video last year, this seems like so long ago, the final price, I think, was $588 with tax. So it's definitely gone up a little bit. So let's talk about how to easily afford these sneakers, because this is not going to be the only thing on your plate that you need to take care of. There's always the essentials. There's always those first four I talk about in my free budgeting ebook. You need to make sure you take care of the roof over your head, the food on the table, the essential clothes on your back, and then transportation to get to and from wherever you need to get to, whether it's school, you know, work, grocery store, wherever you need to get to. Make sure that you're taking care of that too. Very simple. We are going to start now, okay? Now. So the very simple thing you do, $610, just go ahead and divide that by 6, because we're going to save in June, July, August, September, October, November. This is going to be to your benefit. It's going to cost you about, what, $102 a month? To make sure that you don't have any issue affording this shoe, no problems. Chance, I told you, we want no problems, big fellow. We want no problems. You want to easily secure your pair, no matter the size, when that time arrives. But more importantly, this is for the families that really need the full family size room. So you're setting aside $102 every single month. That means you are still, within reason, able to do other things you want to do. If there are other shoes coming out in the summer you want to buy, you can do it. If there are clothes that you want to add to the wardrobe, you can do that. If there are deals, which there are tons of deals right now at stores trying to get rid of product, you can do that. This is all to your benefit. Make it easy on yourself. Make it possible so you don't stress, because I guarantee you somebody will say, whether it's on YouTube or on Instagram or somewhere on social media, man, I just don't know how I'm gonna afford like this whole full family size run. This is just gonna be so daunting on me. I don't know that I can do it. Well, let's not act brand new. You knew the shoe was gonna release December 12th if you were not living under a rock. And you know that you also have Christmas and other things to take care of. So make sure that you are taking care of your business always. So it's very simple. Set aside $102 a month in your budget. Put it aside, save it. Don't use it, don't touch it, don't do anything to it. That way when December arrives, you're able to get a full family size run, no problems, no issues. So hopefully that helps somebody out. If you were just, it was all gonna just seem overwhelming to have to drop $610 in December while taking care of Christmas and everything else. Hope this helped. As always, act your age, not your shoe size. I'm still curious to see what the final rendering will look like, but stay tuned. Peace out.